Checking on Money Matters, it is becoming more common to skip work the day after a big sporting event. And next year, the U.S. will export more energy than it imports. That hasn't happened since 1953.
Jane King is joining us live from the NASDAQ this morning with these stories and much more in today's Money Matters report. Happy Friday to you, Jane.
Happy Friday.
Yeah, so the U.S. about to do something it hasn't done in 67 years.
Yeah, pretty incredible. So the U.S. poised to become a net energy exporter starting next year. And this is thanks to the shale oil, the natural gas boom that we've seen for the past 15 years or so. The U.S. will export more energy than it imports in 2020 for the first time since 1953. So this is according to a report published by the Energy Department. So in a short amount of time, it's been a huge change in kind of global economics, and particularly with oil.
And word is American homeowners are ready to spend big to improve their homes.
Yes, so a report from UBS found that homeowners plan to spend about $7,000 on average this spring for home improvement products. So these are things that they say homeowners try to make their homes look better. They're also fixing broken stuff around the house, taking on projects that they put off. So the spring is Christmas for Lowe's and Home Depot, and they do expect to benefit from that trend.
And deep spring cleaning, we'll call it. So
yes.
Are we talking about MoviePass again? I mean, seriously, back and forth, back and forth. They're bringing back the unlimited plan next week.
Well, Variety talked to the CEO of the company, and he says they will announce some sort of unlimited plan next week. They didn't go into details how much it's going to cost and so forth. Now, experts say it's safe to say this will probably not have that old price of $9.99. So that was a big money loser for them. But we'll see what they unveil next week, I guess.
It's also safe to say it's going to change again. Jane, more than half of professionals know someone who's skipped work the day after a major sporting event.
Yes, employee absenteeism after major sports events like the Super Bowl is on the rise. Now, this is according to a research from the staffing firm Office Team. It says more than half of professionals, 54%, know someone who's called in sick or made an excuse for skipping work following a big game. And managers in Cleveland, Denver, and Chicago were the most annoyed by this absenteeism. So I don't know. Halftime at the Super Bowl, and I gotta usually go to bed. So,
By the way, happy early birthday.
Oh yeah,
thank you.
Tomorrow.
Yes,
aww.
It's tomorrow. I get a Saturday birthday this year.
Yeah.
So
what are Jean and the kids gonna do?
We're gonna go out and eat. It's a winter fair at the school, so I'm gonna be helping there, and then we're gonna go out and eat dinner.
Very nice. So. We'll have a happy.
Yes, thank you.